Hello and welcome, my friend. Here is the car doctor Peter Finn. And next, I am planning to show you, my friend, great idea that what is 5 tips for replacing the seat. And here is really very nice high quality seat what now I am planning to replace in this my car's driver's area in that area. Okay, and what are those my tips that how I can replace this my new seat and how I can install that in there, and is this actually really possible? Because this sometimes it might looks very easy that this is very good seat and how I install this seat in there. And now, my friend, this is for you if you are not the expert. This could be really difficult, that my current case, because now this my high quality seat, this black one, this is from Honda Civic cars, and in there, in back, there is this my car, what is Ford Focus. And now I am planning to install Honda's seat to Ford car. And this is possible if I work like a couple of days, I can manage to do that. But now there is 1% chance that if we do so that I have car likes Ford and then I am planning to install in their Honda's seats, that it fit right away. 1% chance. But let's look that what I need to check that I can do that seat replace, and next those 5 tips for you what are planning to replace and swap new seat to your car or truck. Okay, first thing is of course that if we like to do this in right way and way that we can do that very easy and fast way, we have to find just similar car. Just this is tip number one. When we are replacing seat, we have to find Ford Focus car and same year model, and then these seats fit about 100% in new car and this replace car. Okay, and this is tip number one. We have to find just similar year model and same car brand and this model car's seat, and also it must be in same side seat. Now we can see that when I am planning to replace this driver's seat, I have in here this passenger seat, because there is this belt. Look, belt is in this red area. This is in wrong position, because in driver's area it should be in here. Even if this is, if I live in England, in UK, there is this driver's side seat, but in USA I have to be this left side driver's seat. And this is now like in right side driver's seat, wrong position. This is from England, this is English model, and this is from USA, Ford Focus and Honda Civic from London. This is the issue. But we can install these Honda Civics seats also in US Hondas. Okay, and this is like first tip. And the second tip is same thing, that if we have some car what is like in Ford Taurus and Ford Focus, then we have chance in USA that we can install Ford Focus seat to this Ford Taurus. It is possible. If we can find same car brand's seat, it is possible that if we have Ford 150 truck, we can install these seats to Ford 250. It is possible that if we have truck like Ford F-150, we can install these seats to 250. Okay, this is if we have same car brand. This is tip number two. And then we go in that my topic that how then if I like to install this my Honda Civic seat to this Ford Focus. First point is that I have to check those mounting point and mounting holes in this my seat that they are just similar then in this my Ford Focus. And let's go to check that what I mean. And we have to go next look at my seat more closer. Okay, and then these seat mountings, they are these things in here, these holes in here. And now when I little bit rotate that, we can see more closer these things in here. Okay, and these are seat mounting bolt holes. And now when I am installing this my seat in this new car, I have to take my measurement, this tool in use, and then I have to firstly measure that what is this hole's distance in here. This is first step. And in that my car, new seat, it is 38 centimeter. And this is like first step when I am installing this new seat in my old car, that this area is same. First this length. And this is first measurement. And then second is that what is this length in here? And now I measure these two holes distance. There is one hole and one in here. And now I measure these things. And these things are, there is 43 centimeters. And this is like basic thing when we start to think that can I install this new seat in my old car. And let's look these areas closer. And then this tip 3 was that I have to look at these holes. And now we can do these holes bigger, but if they are like in wrong position in this new seat, then it is really difficult because I have to weld in here these parts, and this is so difficult that it is almost impossible to do. And then I have to check that these mounting, these plates are in same area than in my old car. And then let's go to look next mounting point. And here we have this front mounting point, and in that area we have to check that this my new seats, this plate is in this plane. It is like horizontally in here. That must be checked. And also I have to check that this amount that where it is installing, this is same this deepness in here. This is like third point. And if I have managed to check these things, and now when I know that what is this length and what is this wide, and then what in what shape we have this mounting points, now we can go to look in this my Ford Focus that is this any possibility to install these seats in there, that what are these Ford Focus firstly this length, and let's go to do that. Okay, and there is this first mounting point in this Ford car, and I take my flathead screwdriver and I have to remove this area. And now we can see that there is this first bolt in here. And now I install this my measurement tool in here, and second is in here little bit in that area in here in this point. And now when I measure this distance from here to here, it is about 40 centimeters. 40 centimeters. Okay. Now I can see that this is 40 centimeters. And now I have to compare these things that is the same this length in like that my new seat. And now I believe that there is 3 centimeters difference, and it was too much. Or actually it is 2 centimeters difference. This my Ford Focus is 40 centimeters and Honda's it is 38, and it is like 2 centimeters, and it is too much. And then I noticed that this my Ford's, this front mounting is in wrong type. And let's go to look that. And then when we look that type, this is in wrong type, because in Honda's it was in that area. And now I have in here two big challenge, that mountings are now wrong. Okay, but then we go to tip number 4. Okay, and then tip number 4 is that what is this my seat belts type and how this fits to our new car. And now I have in here this Honda's seat belt, and I have even this old seat belt in here that I can install that in here. And now I have to only check that when I am replacing this new seat, that this seat belt works also in my old car. And now we can see more that we have to check that we have similar seat belt lock in my old car, because otherwise I have issues. And let's go to look that area next. Okay, and there we can see those Ford Focus cars seat belt locks, and there is this my Honda's test example, and let's look that how they works. Okay, and now I have issue that this is too big. And if we have thing that this my old cars, this seat belt lock, this, if this don't fit to our new seat, then we have big troubles, because this seat belts replace, this is really difficult thing, because there are specific bolts and nuts, and these are mandatory things in our this traffic control and these government things, that this is not good idea if I need to replace also in Ford Focus cars these Honda Civic cars seat belts. Okay, and that's tip number 4, that seat belts must fit. And now as we can see that this Honda's belt, if we compare in this my old, this is Honda and this is my current, Honda is too big and too wide. Okay, and this is like tip number 4. And let's go to tip number 5. Okay, and then tip number 5 is that how fits this my new replace seats and old seats electric cables. And it happens so that I rotate this my seat here, and then we can see that there are some cables in their down area. And now I am meaning these cables. And these cables must fit directly to my old car. And here is like one, and this is second cable. And these are like cut, and this is not good idea, because I need now connectors. And now I believe that there could be some difficulties if I have seat where are not suitable connectors for this my Ford car. And let's go to look at what kind of connectors Ford car have. Okay, and then when we look in that Ford car's down area, there is this my cable. And then we look that area, and now I can see that, oh no, these cables are totally different in Ford cars. And that means now that this is bad stopper, if we can see that there is, these connectors are totally different. Because we need also these cables. They are also ABS and airbag sensor cables. They are included in here. This seat includes also airbag sensor in here. And that is like tip number 5. That if connectors are bad, then we have to stop that job. And that's, we have to check all of these 5 things before of that when we replace these seats. And that kind of information, my friend, and see you in next movie.